وإن كتاب الله أوثق شافع وأغنى غناء واهبا متفضيلا وخير جليس لا يمل حديثه وترداده يزداد فيه تجملا.
Inshallah ta'ala, now we're going to go into Nash'atu ilm al-Qira'at, the historical development in which ilm al-Qira'at went through. Ilm al-Qira'at started the day the Qur'an descended on the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to the Prophet, Iqra, recite and read, that's when it started. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned that in the Qur'an, He said, وَإِنَّهُ لَتَنْزِيلُ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ نَزَلَ بِهِ الرُّوحُ الْأَمِينَ عَلَىٰ قَلْبِكَ لِتَكُونَ مِنَ الْمُنْذِرِينَ بِلِسَانٍ عَرَبِيٍ مُبِينٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He told us, وَإِنَّهُ لَتَنْزِيلُ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ, that this Qur'an is a revelation sent down from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. نَزَلَ بِهِ الرُّوحُ الْأَمِينَ, Jibreel came down with it. Then Jibreel is the wasita, the intermediary between Allah and the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the Qur'an came down in the Arabic language, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in that verse. Also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said, وَمَا يَنْطِقُ عَنِ الْهَوَىٰ إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا وَحْيٌ يُوحَىٰ عَلَّمَهُ شَدِيدُ الْقُوَىٰ, that this Prophet, يعني Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he doesn't speak from his own whims and desires. What he speaks and what he says to you all is a revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah also told us subhanahu wa ta'ala to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when the revelation came down, لا تحرك به لسانك لتعجل به إن علينا جمعه وقرآنه فإذا قرأناه فاتبع قرآنه ثم إن علينا بيانه. Allah mentioned to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, do not move your lips, do not move your tongue, because the Prophet ﷺ wanted to memorize fast. Abdullah ibn Abbas narrated, as it's found in Sahih al-Bukhari, he said, كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, that the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم يعالج من التنزيل شدة وكان مما يحرك شفتيه, that when the revelation would come down on the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he would move his lips, he would want to recite with Jibreel. فأنزل الله تعالى, Allah sent down on the Prophet, لا تحرك به لسانك لتعجل به, do not move your tongue Muhammad, do not move your lips, listen to the Quran and we're going to pour it into your heart, Allah said to him. فكان رسول الله بعد ذلك, after that verse came down, after that, إذا أتاه جبريل, if Jibreel came to the Prophet, استمع, the Prophet would, he would listen attentively to him. فإذا انطلق جبريل, and when Jibreel would leave, قرأه النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كما قرأه, the messenger would recite it the way Jibreel recited it to him. So what you learn from this as well is that Jibreel was the intermediary between Allah and the messenger. He was the one who was passing the Quran onto the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. So this is when it started. This was the starting point. Our messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, after he took the Quran from Jibreel, after the Quran was sent down on him, He was commanded to convey this recitation. He was commanded to convey this message, this Qur'an. He was commanded to convey it to the people. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said to him, يَا أَيُّهَا الرَّسُولُ بَلِّغْ مَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْكَ مِنْ رَبِّكَ وَإِنْ لَمْ تَفْعَلْ فَمَا بَلَّغْتَ رِسَالَتَهُ وَاللَّهُ يَعْصِمُكَ مِنَ النَّاسِ. Muhammad, convey that which has been sent down onto you. يعني the Qur'an, convey it, pass it on. Give it to the Sahabas. Teach them the Qur'an. And our Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he did so. He stood up and he taught his companions the Qur'an. That's why Allah said in another ayah, مَا عَلَى الرَّسُولِ إِلَّا الْبَلَاغِ, there is nothing upon the Prophet except to convey. In another ayah, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He said, فَاصْدَعْ بِمَا تُؤْمَرْ وَأَعْرِضْ عَنِ الْمُشْرِكِينَ. Muhammad, stand up and convey the message and turn away from the disbelievers, the polytheists, turn away from them. So the Qur'an was given to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and then he was told to convey what he was given. And he did so. He passed it on. He gave it to his companions. And our Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not distort the Qur'an. He gave it exactly as it was given to him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us in the Qur'an, وَإِذَا تُتْلَ عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتُنَا بَيِّنَاتٍ قَالَ الَّذِينَ لَا يَرْجُونَ لِقَاءَ نَأْتِ بِقُرْآنٍ غَيْرِ هَذَا أَوْ بَدِّلْهُ قُلْ مَا يَكُونُ لِي أَنْ أُبَدِّلَهُ مِنْ تِلْقَاءِ نَفْسِي إِنْ أَتَّبِعُ إِلَّا مَا يُوحَى إِلَيَّ إِنِّي أَخَافُ إِنْ عَصَيْتُ رَبِّي عَذَابَ يَوْمٍ عَظِيمٍ قُلْ لَوْ شَاءَ اللَّهُ مَا تَلَوْتُوهُ عَلَيْكُمْ وَمَا أَدْرَاكُمْ بِهِ فَقَدْ لَبِثْتُ فِيكُمْ عُمُرًا مِنْ قَبْلِهِ أَفَلَا تَعْقِلُونَ. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala tells us in this verse, وَإِذَا تُتْلَ عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتُنَا Muhammad, when you recite on these people our verses, قَالَ الَّذِينَ لَا يَرْجُونَ لِقَاءَنَا, the disbelievers, the ones who are not hoping to meet us, the ones who don't believe in the Day of Judgment, and they do not believe that they're going to be resurrected. What do they say? They say to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, اِئْتِ بِقُرْآنٍ غَيْرِ هَذَا, bring us a Qur'an other than this. Oh, بَدِّلْهُ, or change it. Distort this one and give us something else. Then the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم said to them, قُلْ مَا يَكُونُ لِي أَنْ أُبَدِّلَهُ مِنْ تِلْقَاءِ نَفْسِي, I cannot change this Qur'an from myself. It's a revelation sent onto me. I have to convey exactly as it was given to me. I have no rights to change it. I can't change it. In another verse, Allah تبارك وتعالى told us that if the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم even tried to change the Qur'an, if he tried to add something to the Qur'an, if he tried to subtract from the Qur'an, that Allah will destroy him. Allah said, وَلَوْ تَقَوَّلَ عَلَيْنَا بَعْضَ الْأَقَاوِيلِ لَأَخَذْنَا مِنْهُ بِالْيَمِينِ ثُمَّ لَقَطَعْنَا مِنْهُ الْوَتِينِ. Muhammad, if you lied about us, or if he lied about us, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he says, وَلَوْ تَقَوَّلَ عَلَيْنَا بَعْضَ الْأَقَاوِيلِ, if he lied about us some places, here or there, added extra wow here, added an extra letter here, subtracted something from here. And if he tries to play around with our religion, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, I will destroy him. I'm going to all give you, inshallah ta'ala, a rational argument. After I gave you all those textual evidences from the Qur'an, I'm going to give you a rational argument. Let's say there was a powerful king, an extremely powerful king, and this king has a kingdom. And there is someone within that kingdom. He does things. And whenever he does something and he's asked, why are you doing this? He says, I have the approval of the king. Now we know this king is powerful. He has the ability to harm him or reward him. The question here is, this person, let's say, lives for 23 years in that kingdom. And he says, this is what the king wants me to do, and this is what the king told me not to do, and he prohibited me from this, and he allowed me this for 23 years. And that king lets him do what he wants. The king, if he's being lied about, and it wasn't what he said, he'll grab that person and will destroy them. That's rational argument. That's logic, right? Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam for 23 years was in the kingdom of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He was legislating on behalf of Allah. He was executing on behalf of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He was doing, for 23 years, he was doing things and he was saying, Allah told me this. If the Prophet was lying, Allah would have destroyed him subhanahu wa ta'ala. But he didn't. That shows you his truthfulness, alayhi salatu wasalam. That's what Allah meant, وَلَوْ تَقَوَّلَ عَلَيْنَا بَعْضَ الْأَقَاوِيلِ لَأَخَذْنَا مِنْهُ بِالْيَمِينِ ثُمَّ لَقَطَعْنَا مِنْهُ الْوَتِينِ. If Muhammad lied about us one letter, one thing in this Quran, and said, this is what Allah said, this is what Allah meant, Allah said, we will destroy him. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam conveyed this Quran pure as it was given to him, untampered, unchanged, undistorted. He gave it exactly as it was given to him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That's why Umar ibn Khattab and Zayd ibn Thabit both said, Al-Qira'atu Sunnatu. Qira'ah is a sunnah. Sunnah means taken from those who came before. يأخذها الآخر عن الأول. The one who comes late takes it from the one who is earlier than him. فقرأوا كما علمتموه. Read the Quran as it was taught to you. And the Quran is not read as you wish and the way you want. It was taken from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam took it from Allah. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud said, اتبعوا ولا تبتدعوا فقد كفيتم. Do not innovate. Follow. Read as it was recited to you. Do not innovate in it. فَقَدْ كُفِيتُمْ, you have been sufficed. علي بن أبي طالب رضي الله تعالى عنه, he said, إِنَّ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ يَأْمُرُكُمْ أَن تَقْرَأُوا الْقُرْآنَ كَمَا عُلِّمْتُمْ, that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم is commanding you to read the Qur'an as it was taught to you. What we take from there is that the Qur'an is التلقي والمشافهة, that the Qur'an is taken from the mouth of a teacher who took from another teacher, who took from another teacher, who took from another teacher, who took from the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, who took from Jibreel, who took from Allah عز وجل. And that is why Imam Abu al-Qasim al-Shatibi said in his noble book, حرز الأماني ووجه التهاني في القراءات السبع, he said, وما لقياس في القراءة مدخل فدونك ما فيه الرضا متكفلا, that in the recitation of the Quran there is no independent reasoning. Somebody cannot do a qiyas and say, you know what, I feel like this verse should be recited like this. Malik Yawmiddin, the word Malik, wherever it comes in the Quran, it should be read as Maliki. Maliki. No, it is a talaqi wal mushafaha. Everyone has to have heard it from another teacher, or has to have heard it from a teacher who took from another teacher, who took from another teacher, who took from another teacher, who took from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who took from Jibreel, who took from Allah azza wa jalla. So the Sahabas, they took the Quran ghaddan tariyan kama unzil, pure as it was sent down from the mouth of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and they studied and they learned from him. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he taught them it. Salawatullahi wa salamun alayhi. He taught them in different ahruf, which we're going to speak about inshaAllah ta'ala. ولذلك الإمام الذهبي رحمه الله says something very powerful. He says, فهؤلاء الذين بلغنا أنهم حفظوا القرآن في حياة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وأخذ عنهم عرضا وعليهم دارت أسانيد قراءة الأئمة العشرة وقد جمع القرآن غيرهم من الصحابة كمعاذ بن جبل وأبي زيد وسالم مولى أبي حذيفة وعبد الله بن عمر وعتبة بن عامر لكن لم تتصل بنا قراءاتهم. الإمام الذهبي told us, those sahabas who it has reached us that they have memorized the Quran at the time of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, يعني there were sahabas at the time of the Prophet who memorized the Quran. They took it from the Prophet's mouth, they memorized it to show you that the Prophet taught them the Quran, he passed the Quran on عليه الصلاة والسلام. There were sahabas who memorized the Quran from the Prophet while he was alive. وَأَخَذَ عَنْهُمْ عَرْضًا, and they took from the Prophet the last عَرْضَةُ الْأَخِيرَةُ, يعني the last final version of the Quran. وَعَلَيْهِمْ دَارَتْ أَسَانِيدُ قِرَاءَةٍ أَئِمَّةِ الْعَشَرَةِ, and inshallah ta'ala when we speak about it later, we're going to learn that there are qira'at, qira'ah for the 10 a'imma. We're going to see who they are inshallah ta'ala. Their qira'ah revolves around particular types of companions. But that doesn't mean those are the only sahabas who took the Quran from the Prophet. There are others who took from the Prophet whose chain hasn't reached us. Like كمعاذ بن جبل وأبي زيد وسالم مولى أبي حذيفة وعبد الله بن عمر وعتبة بن عامر, and other than them, لم تتصل بنا قراءاتهم. Their qira'ah hasn't reached us. Their qira'ah hasn't reached us. And we don't have it. But what we take from this point, my beloved brothers and sisters, is the Qur'an came down from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Jibreel brought it to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, without changing it, without altering it, without distorting it, passed it over to his companions as it was given to him. The Sahabas, ridwanullahi alayhim ajma'ina, they went out and taught the Qur'an. They went out to teach the Qur'an, to make the people memorize the Qur'an. They did that, radiallahu anhum. So the Khilafah got taken by Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu. He became Khalifatu Rasulillahi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He took over after the Prophet's death. And as you all are aware of the Islamic history, when Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu took over, a lot of people apostated from Islam. And a man came out known as Musaylamatul Kadhab. He claimed that he is a prophet min indillah. And a group of the people rejected the zakat and they refused to pay the zakat. And at that point, Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu was forced to fight And this fight, the Battle of Yamama, a lot of people died from the Qurra who had memorized the Qur'an. And when a lot of people died, Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu, an idea was presented to him by Umar ibn al-Khattab that the Qur'an should be written and documented, because the Qurra are dying, and if they die and it carries on like this, we may not be able to protect the Qur'an. I'm fearful for it, he said. So it's upon us to protect the Qur'an, he said. When Umar radiallahu anhu presented this idea to Abu Bakr, finally he accepted it and he did it. ولذلك الإمام الشاطبي, he mentions it in a couple of lines of poetry. He says, إِنَّ الْيَمَامَةَ أَهْوَاهَا مُسَيْلَمَةُ الْكَذَّابُ فِي زَمَنِ الصِّدِّيقِ إِذْ خَسِرَا وَبَعْدَ بَأْسٍ شَدِيدٍ حَانَ مَصْرَعُهُ وَكَانَ بَأْسًا عَلَى الْقُرَّاءِ مُسْتَعِرَا نادى أبا بكر الفاروق خفت على القراء فادرك القرآن مستطرا فأجمعوا جمعوا في الصحف واعتمدوا زيد بن ثابت العدل الرضا نظرا فقام فيه بعون الله يجمعه بالنصح والجد والحزم الذي بهرا من كل أوجهه حتى استتم له بالأحرف السبعة العليا كما اشتهرا فأمسك الصحف الصديق ثم إلى الفاروق أسلمها لما قضى العمرا. The day of Yamama, Musaylama, when Abu Bakr fought with him, a large number of the companions died from the Qurra. It was a moment they lost many of the reciters of the Qur'an. So Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu, what he did was, he made a decision to collect the Qur'an. And when he planned to do that, he called onto the noble companion Zayd ibn Thabit. And he said to him, it is upon you to take this responsibility and gather the Qur'an. Now what we have to understand is Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu's aim and objective in doing this is because he wants to gather the Qur'an in all one place. And what he gathered, Abu Bakr, is all of the ahruf al-sab'ah. بِالنُصْحِ وَالْجِدِّ وَالْحَزْمِ الَّذِي بَهَرَى مِنْ كُلِّ أَوْجُهِ حَتَّى اسْتَتَمَّ لَهُ بِالْأَحْرُفِ السَّبْعَةِ الْعُلْيَا كَمَا اشْتَهَرَى. Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu gathered the whole entire ahruf al-sab'ah in one place. And then Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu died. And when Abu Bakr died, ثُمَّ إِلَى الْفَارُوقِ أَسْلَمَهَا لَمَّا قَضَى الْعُمُرَى, Abu Bakr passed it over to Umar. And Umar radiallahu anhu, it stayed with him at the time of his khilafah radiallahu ta'ala anhu. And he kept the Qur'an with him. في أواخر عام 24, when the ending of the 24th year of the Hijriyah and the beginning of the 25th year of the Hijriyah, Uthman radiallahu anhu, he was doing the conquest of Armenia and Azerbaijan. Hudhayfa radiallahu anhu, who participated in the conquest of Hudhayfa ibn al-Yaman, he saw a group of people who were saying to each other, from the awam, from the general mass, saying to one another, that my recitation is better than your recitation, and my recitation is better than your recitation. So Hudhayfa came running back to Uthman ibn Affan, who was the Khalifa at this time. Abu Bakr is dead, Umar died. He came to Uthman ibn Affan. And when he came to Uthman ibn Affan radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said to him, I'm scared, I'm frightened that these people are going to differ amongst themselves like the Christians and the Jews differed amongst themselves. Uthman, do something about this. And then Uthman radiallahu ta'ala anhu requested for the mushaf that was gathered by Abu Bakr. And whose hand is it in this time? When Umar died, he passed it over to his daughter Hafsa. So Hafsa is the one who's got it. ولذلك الإمام الشاطبي said in his حرز الأماني وعند حفصة كانت بعد فاختلف القراء فاعتزلوا في أحرف زمرا وكان في بعض مغزاهم مشاهدهم حذيفة فرأى من خلفهم عبرا فجاء عثمان مذعورا فقال له أخاف أن يخلطوا فأدرك البشرا فاستحضر الصحف الأولى التي جمعت وخص زيدا ومن قريشه نفرا. Al-Imam al-Shatibi says that the Mus'haf was with Hafsa radiallahu ta'ala anha, and Uthman requested for Hafsa to give it to him, and Hafsa gave the Mus'haf to Uthman radiallahu anhu, and Uthman radiallahu anhu, Uthman, what he did was he took this Mus'haf and he made a lejna. He made a committee of four men: Zayd ibn Thabit, Abdullah ibn Zubayr, Sa'id ibn al-As, Abdurrahman ibn al-Harith, all of whom are Quraysh, all of whom are Muhajirin. He requested for these four men to write from this Mus'haf of Uthman radiallahu, Mus'haf that was compiled by Abu Bakr, to make it into one Mus'haf. Because in the Mus'haf of Abu Bakr, there was the al-ahruf al-sab'a, the seven mode of recitation. He wants to, Uthman radiallahu anhu wants to make it into one. So the difference of opinions and the argumentations and the disputes amongst the Muslim comes to an end. So Uthman radiallahu anhu, he made it into one mushaf called Mus'haf al-Imam. And from this mushaf, Uthman radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he told these four men to copy it. And what are they going to do? They're going to copy it, and now this is going to be sent down to the Muslim lands, the headquarters of the Muslim land. And these places were, as Imam al-Shatibi mentioned, وَسَارَ فِي نُسَخٍ مِنْهَا مَعَ الْمَدَنِي كُوفٍ وَشَامٍ وَبَصْرٍ تَمْلَأُ الْبَصَرَى وَقِيلَ مَكَّةُ وَالْبَحْرَيْنِ مَعَ يَمَنٍ ضَاعَتْ بِهَا نُسَخٌ فِي نَشْرِهَا قُطُرًا. يعني they took it to Medina, Kufa, Sham, Basra. And some said, no, it was Mecca, Bahrain, Yemen, and etc. So Uthman radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he commanded that the masahif be sent to these places. Now, these masahif were sent with reciters. They weren't sent alone. And the people weren't allowed to just get the mushaf and read as they want. These masahif that Uthman radiallahu anhu, Uthman's got the main one, and the copies that were written from it were given to reciters. Just give it to these places: Medina, Kufa, Sham, Basra, and etc. Some of the masahif had variation, but these variations were based on recitation that the Sahabas took from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Like, for example, Surah At-Tawbah, where Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he said, تَجْرِي تَحْتَهَا الْأَنْهَارِ. Ibn Kathir recites it as, تَجْرِي مِن تَحْتِهَا الْأَنْهَارِ. Now someone might come and say, but in the Mus'haf of Kufa, it doesn't have مِن تَحْتِهَا الْأَنْهَارِ. We say in the Mus'haf of Mecca, it had مِن تَحْتِهَا الْأَنْهَارِ, that Uthman radiallahu anhu sent. So these were the masahif that were sent. And these masahif became the source of where the Qur'an was taken from. From here, the Sahabas taught the Qur'an based on the mushaf that was sent. And in all of those regions, reciters, qurra, 10 of whom, inshallah ta'ala, in our upcoming episodes we're going to talk about, they came from these Sahabas. They took from these tabi'een and the tabi'u tabi'een wa hakada until the Qur'an reached us the way it has reached us today. That is, inshallah ta'ala, a summary, a quick summary of how the Qur'an, the Qira'at, evolved from the time of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam until the time of the Qurra'i Sab'ah, the Qurra al-Ashara, the Aimatul Ashara, the 10 reciters. We're going to go in more details in our next series, our next episodes, inshallah ta'ala. Keep an eye out for that, inshallah ta'ala.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. How can you do a 2-second action right now that will give you a share of the reward of everything we're doing on this YouTube channel? Simple. Like this video and click subscribe. Why? It will allow YouTube to recommend our videos to other users. And imagine the huge amount of reward that could be waiting for you on the Day of Judgment if you did that with a sincere intention of spreading the Deen of Allah. You'll be rewarded for every single person who benefits from one of our videos as a result of your like or subscribe. That's an easy 2-second action that you definitely don't want to miss out on. Do it now, click like and subscribe, and don't forget to make that intention.